My name is Drew Hobbs. I'm a second-year master's student working under Dr. Jeremy Testa here at the Chesapeake Biological Lab. The main focus of my research is to look at nutrient cycling within water bodies that tie into the Chesapeake Bay. Just like humans need nutrients to help sustain life for them, all the organisms within the Chesapeake Bay also need nutrients. When you have too many nutrients, it can cause problems where you have low oxygen levels in the water, which can contribute to things like fish kills. My research is looking at three creeks that are in Pasadena, Maryland, one of which is of particular interest because it actually has a very large-scale aeration system. And basically, that aeration system operates in the same way that a fish tank works. This allows us a very unique opportunity to take two comparison sites and look at how nutrient cycling operates within those two creeks versus Rock Creek, which has that controlled aeration. This large-scale aeration system was actually installed into Rock Creek in the 1980s to help alleviate some of the problems that low dissolved oxygen had, like fish kills and a very bad foul odor emanating from the creek. The Chesapeake Bay is obviously a very large body of water, so looking at smaller creeks and tributaries offers a very good opportunity to take that data and compile it with other research to apply that to the Chesapeake Bay as a whole. When I go in the field for my research, I collect water and sediment samples to analyze them for different concentrations of nitrogen. So after the water samples are collected in the field and brought back to the lab, I extract the gas from the very top of the water in the bottle and then inject it into the gas chromatograph so that I can look at the levels of nitrous oxide within that specific sample. A gas chromatograph works by separating the different compounds in the air and breaking them down into individual peaks so that you can look at the specific levels of each individual compound. I'm interested in looking at nitrous oxide because it has a very large role in the nitrogen cycle and is a greenhouse gas that's about 300 times more potent than carbon dioxide. So by understanding how various oxygen levels can affect nitrogen cycling within a small system like the ones that I'm studying, we can apply that to the Chesapeake Bay as a whole, which can really help us understand how these nutrient inputs can affect the water quality of the watershed.